Welcome to 3Count Commentaries. This is your host, Mongo Slay, and today we're going to get mocked by Voices of Wrestling because, you know, it's not enough to be a know-it-all wrestling fan. You have to also tell people what kind of wrestling they should like, which, you know, I know we all do that, but by God, these dudes are so boring. They have no personality whatsoever outside of hating something. But let's get into it. The article is called The Movie Guide for the Wrestling Fan That Does Not Want Wrestling. We're not going to go through this whole thing because it's kind of ridiculous. But we're going to get the gist of it, and then we're going to talk about it. We're going to actually skim through it a little bit. So he says here, for the last few years, I have been paying attention to social media and seeing people referring to some segments in pro wrestling as cinema. Hence, this is my contribution to the world. Film recommendations for the wrestling fan that wants less wrestling. And it says, whether it's comedy skits that have people throwing smiley faces on Twitter, or people loving worlds where people die, or maybe just horror movie tropes with this Wyatt 6-6 that give them goosebumps. Some fans have been really loving these things and referring to them as storytelling. Hell, some fans have been loving them when matches stop halfway and the wrestlers just talk to each other to let the audience know what's going on. Even long promo segments are being applauded. So, you're not supposed to be interested in comedy in your wrestling. You're not allowed to have verbal jousting in your wrestling. Promos are a problem. You can't talk. Outlandish characters are not supposed to be a thing. So, what are you watching? It's got to be like that boring Japanese shit, right? Because even if you're in Lucha Libre, everybody's running around in a mask playing a character. So it's not Lucha. And it certainly can't be American. Well, the guy's name is, I forgot to say what his name is, Abraham Delgado, which would tell you he's Hispanic. So a Hispanic guy going off on Lucha, when you have El Santo comic books, you're telling me that this, when El Santo is doing movies, we're supposed to say, we don't know what kind of fan he is. He might be like some 30-something with a European mindset. And by a European mindset, what I mean is these guys who are European wrestling fans, you know, the boring kind. You know, very Voices of Wrestling, What Culture, those kinds of guys. They're very boring. They like strictly 90s All Japan and all that kind of shit. They're super boring. Just very boring guys. And if you're the kind of guy who just, you're not into the personalities, I don't understand what you're watching. Personalities are like 90% of the business. That's what people watch for. Even the wrestlers that you watch, most of them got to the top due to personality, you know, in some way, or how their personality is perceived in the public. Even if it's a sort of a person to me that would be boring, like Masaharu Misawa. To the Japanese, he has an interesting personality. And he might have had a personality that was more something that they get invested in. Not me, though. I just think that he's boring, you know, so, but whatever. So he's talking about how films are the best and why read books, why go to theaters. He says, how do I know film is the best art form? When people like something in pro wrestling a lot, they refer to it as cinema. Hence, cinema is the best art form, superior to all others. Well, this is incorrect. They're actually memeing on Scorsese, who said that the Avengers movies are not cinema. He was the one who created the concept. So they're basically memeing this guy. You know, some of it is a meme. Some of it is legitimate. But that would be like somebody saying that, you know, a thing is based and then you taking it literally. You know, or, you know, man, that girl's hot. Like, she really has like a high temperature or something. It's like, how do you not have basic, how do you not know slang? Cinema is just slang. You're overthinking it. You're really overthinking it. He continues by saying, you never watch a 40-minute Bloodline segment or the Magic Show on Raw and go, that's theater, even though that's the closest actual comparison. You don't watch Sami Zayn's entrance in Montreal and think, that's like a sports broadcast. The answer to all of this is films. Again, it's slang, it's a meme. why are you being such a stick in the mud? People, how do you listen to these guys? Seriously. Ugh, these dudes suck. All right, so let's see what, I'm not going to go into their movie preferences. Let's see what they actually take issue with. So it says, quote, for the fans that love horror, people really like it when the Wyatt Six kill WWE production team and Chad Gable, even though Gable is alive. Who knows? It was never assumed that they were dead. We memed that he was dead. Everybody knew he literally would not be dead. Lucha Underground did things in which people actually died. WWE has never done anything where somebody actually died. Well, Owen Hart died. But I mean, like, actually died in character. Even Muhammad Hassan, nobody ever said he was dead. It was never assumed that Chad Gable was dead or that the production team was dead. You know, you can lay down on the ground and be bleeding and not be dead. You realize that, right? Very, very odd. For the fan that like to look for clues. He says, as we know, WWE fans love to look for clues and QR codes on their TV screens. They love to have a bit of horror in their lives. Confusion. Clues. Maybe they are looking for an experience that combines all of that. What's wrong with the QR codes and stuff? I didn't follow it particularly. Not that I don't have an issue with that. But what is the problem with it? What's the problem with little additions that to the show that don't really distract from the show, that take you to other places and other things? It's just using technology to further your story, which is no different than a guy using social media, because that's literally what it is. It's videos and different things like that that you can find on like Twitter or Instagram or whatever. Do you have a problem with technology being involved with wrestling? I mean, this is so stupid. For those that love talking between matches. I don't understand this. I know what you're thinking. That stupid match is in the middle of my storytelling. It happens to me too. What? Let's get to the end of this. He says, maybe the pesky wrestling match is always interrupting the conversation. And pro wrestling has all of the answers. Andre and Wallace? Oh, from My Dinner with Andre. 19. Oops. He doesn't even have any good taste in movies. In any event, I guess there was a hyperlink in here about Roman Reigns basically trash talking people during this match, which should not be a big deal considering Rock did it, Austin did it. But I guess, again, boring, no personality. You're supposed to be, what? Are we watching Olympic wrestling now? You know, those guys aren't allowed to talk to each other. Even in boxing, dudes trash talk each other. Even in mixed martial arts, dudes mock and trash talk each other. In football, in basketball, in baseball, in all sports, hockey, guys will stop the action to trash talk each other if they can. What is the issue here, actually? It would be one thing if he says, like, there's an excessive amount of this, but I just don't get it. It's stupid. But you have to be, I guess he's trying to be fair. And he's saying, for those who want to laugh, maybe you are missing the brochachos in AEW. And they're really funny comedy. Maybe all you want in pro wrestling is funny stuff. There's nothing wrong with adding comedy to wrestling. Now, it's not a comedy. You know, everybody can't do comedy. But so what if there is comedy? Again, personality, different takes on things. What is the issue here? Well, he actually likes the other guys, so I can say it's not terrible. The other guys is great. I think that movie was great. For those that love Timeless Tony, and he basically talked about the movie that the character is based on, which is like, so what? We're not. Relax. For those that love the new WWE camera angles, I know these fans. They all about cinematography. Don't worry, guys, I got you. Since Sami Zayn having a cool entrance and a static shot at cinema, I don't have one, but two movie recommendations. I think people just like the shot, man. People just like the camera shot stuff. That's really all it is. They improve because years of cuts. People are now overplaying the really long singular shot in WWE today. but it's not that big a deal. It really, some people are very excited about it, but then again, wrestling fans get very excited about anything. But it's pretty stupid, if you ask me, but whatever. For those that want to watch attractive people do stuff, well, that's every television show, isn't it? Isn't that every TV show? It says, mostly when NXT comes into my eyes, it's either wrestlers doing moves out of their depth or attractive people having bad backstage segments. Wrestlers doing things out of their depth. I don't know. How many times have I... Oh, well, let's not go into the AEW botch stuff. Or how, you know, some of your beloved Japanese guys, you know, literally paralyzed or died in the ring. Because, you know, hey, dropping each other literally on each other's heads is how pro wrestling is supposed to be done. I'm pretty sure Gorgeous George and Luthez were all about that. You know, I'm pretty sure they were all about backdrop drivers and Tiger Driver 91s onto the top of their goddamn head. I'm pretty sure they were thrilled to do that. You know, those guys would have killed you if you'd have dropped them on their head. It was not part of the show, okay? But, yeah, you should also want to see attractive people do stuff, especially women. I don't see a problem with that. It seemed to me like he didn't want to say women, but that seems to be where we were going with this. So he continues. Well, his conclusion. So he actually successfully skipped through this thing. As you can see, you can get your fix for horror, comedy, drama, cinematography, and gate skip writing from films. Pro wrestling is not the only medium doing these things of this nature. Here's the thing, but pro wrestling is the only place where you can get all of those things in one. Like, you don't always get horror, comedy, drama, and good cinematography in one movie. Or at least bits of it in one movie. What you did, stupidly, of course, is you picked genres. And then you said, watch this genre of movie. It's like, okay, but maybe I don't want to watch 2 hours of Wyatt Six. Maybe I don't want to watch 2 hours of R-Truth. Maybe I don't want to watch the other guys, even though the movie is great. I don't feel like watching it all the time. Maybe I don't want to see 2 hours of comedy. Maybe there needs to be some action in between the promos and the character work. I mean, this type of article is so ridiculous because it really just shows you how uppity and how elitist this version of wrestling fan really is. There's nothing in here. Everything in here is about attacking somebody or mocking them for liking something, even though what they actually like is a small part of the show. The Wyatt stuff has not like taken over Raw or anything like that. It's an active part of Raw, but it hasn't like taken the show over. You know, NXT is like mostly attractive people doing stuff, especially women. Comedy used to be a larger part of Raw back in Vince's days, but it's a, you know, smaller part of Raw now. Not everybody does comedy anymore. But the only wrestling company I can think of that doesn't really partake in this stuff is maybe CMLL, which is a very boring product as far as I'm concerned, and a lot of the Japanese stuff. But even in Japan, they still have promotions where people do wild and crazy stuff like wrestle blow-up dolls, which these guys, oddly enough, never seem to condemn. They wrestle children, which, you know, again, they never seem to condemn. Guys get finger banged, fingers in their butthole. You never see these people condemn this kind of stuff. You know, there's a guy running around with a cheese grater on AEW TV. Nobody in Voices of Wrestling ever condemns that stuff. You never see them condemn that kind of shit. It's always whatever WWE is doing at the moment is the worst thing and it's not pro wrestling. And it's like, well, they set the standard 40 years ago that they do more than pro wrestling. They do sports entertainment. That the characters are outlandish, they're colorful, they're braggadocious, sometimes they're humorous, sometimes they're supposed to be scary. Sometimes they're supposed to be just wacky animal-themed characters. But you see this stuff everywhere. There's like a guy running around in a barbarian costume in Mexico. There's a guy walking around with bullhorns in Mexico. Nobody ever talks trash about these people, you know? Like, nobody ever talks shit about the weird stuff that they do in other countries. It's almost always the weird stuff that's going on in the United States. And I don't understand that. You know, a couple of years ago, I started saying things like New Japan and that kind of thing is like the vegetables of pro wrestling. Like, you're supposed to like it. You're forced to like it, you know, and you're a problem if you don't like it. But these guys don't seem to get that people have different tastes. It's the same thing with like boom bap hip hop, or, you know, to double back to the Scorsese element, where you think that there can only be one version of these things. You know, movies are supposed to be long, drawn out dramas with good cinematography and good acting, which, you know, that's good. It works. But the big, fun, dumb action movie is actually pretty good, too. You know, the comedy is pretty good, too. The romance, for those of who like that, might be okay, too. You don't get to decide what other people like. And people produce what other people enjoy, you know. But turning what you supposedly like, that is bland, no seasoned pro wrestling, how dare you have comedy, intentional comedy, how dare you have romance, how dare you have horror, how dare you care that these people are attractive. You're supposed to just care about moves and matches. That's it. Don't do anything else. And to think that is what anything should be. It's like rap is not just lyrics. It's also production and personality and songwriting. And is the song catchy? Sometimes the song could be catchy and the lyrics is whack. It's still a rap song, you know? And, you know, sometimes the actors aren't the best, but it's good action movie. You got to get over that kind of stuff, man. Being elitist about these sorts of things never really further the progress of the genre that you're supposedly a fan of. It only hinders it. As people who come in to do different things, often will take the genre in different directions, expanding on it and making it more palatable for more people. But I guess if you just want to watch Olympic wrestling with everybody running around in a similar spandex outfit, and if that's what you want, go for it. But most of us will just turn out when that happens. You know, because it's not the 1940s anymore. And even then, you had Gorgeous George, and you had a couple of other guys with the bleach blonde hair and, you know, the feathered boas or the feathered robes or something like that. The guys who talked a lot, you know, that stuff existed even in the 40s. So I don't even know what this guy is watching that got him to thinking that all of these things are bad. But let me know what you guys think. Like, share, subscribe. I'll talk to you guys later. Peace out.